snow-capped mountains, lush green valleys, a feisty salmon at the end of a fly rod. Tug Hannon, you're not in Florida anymore.
This is exciting.
Fishing Norway. That's the focus of today's Sportsman's Challenge. This haunting tune is born out of a tradition as old as Norwegian Lapp culture. It is an homage to one mountain. Set in this majestic landscape, a mountain which has provided the necessities of life for our singer Michael and his ancestors for more than 1,000 years. It is but one of the thousands of spectacular settings which lure visitors to Norway. However, the scenery and history of this country are an added attraction for our own Doug Hannon. He's winging his way across the Atlantic Ocean to explore pristine Norwegian waters and to immerse himself in time-honored fishing traditions. The experience begins north of the Arctic Circle, in the northernmost town in the world, Hammerfest. Thanks to the Gulf Stream current, the city is a thriving year-round seaport. Oil and commercial fishing are its lifeblood. Nearly 10,000 hardy residents and a few reindeer make Hammerfest their home. Joining Doug in Hammerfest is Toril Kolbu, a world champion fly caster and fly tier. Her expertise has taken her to all four corners of the world. But Norway is home, and she is justifiably proud of what her country has to offer. Grayling, char, salmon, and trout all populate the streams and rivers of Norway. The angling possibilities are endless, and Toril is here to share her knowledge of fly fishing with Doug.
Toril, this is my first time in your world, so you have to tell me what to do.
I will try my very best. We are going to fish salmon here with a two-hand rod.
Two fly rod, two-hand fly rod.
Yes, 15 foot long. So I will show you a little bit how you
use to cast.
To cast.
Yes.
Yeah, and
maybe you show me more than a little bit.
And the flies for this river. Flies with the white and gray.
Terrell's own flies too.
Yeah, it's very good pattern for this river. So we start with the gray dry fly first. And if that don't work, we try these ones.
Okay. That's great.
So today, the bass professor becomes the student, eager to learn new fly casting skills from the expert. Their classroom is a stretch of the Repperfjord River.
You're holding the running line between your fingers, and you hold the butt.
Oh, okay.
And just you see, you use the, and then you let go.
The salmon of this crystal clear water are easily spooked, so Doug and Toril must use the two-handed rods in order to keep their distance. It is here that Doug encounters his first Norwegian Sportsman's Challenge.
Is it a rock?
A fish?
I think it must be a rock.
Yeah.
There are salmon in this pool, but Doug needs a bit more practice to master the art of placing the fly in just the right spot.
That's nice, fast.
I get it.
It's no problem.
They say practice makes perfect. When practice involves casting a very long fly rod for a few hours, it also makes a hungry angler.
I had a lot of new experiences, but I don't think I've had one quite as new as this. And the sun's like right here, it's high noon.
Our hosts from Hammerfest and the Skady Hotels are ready to remedy the situation with a shore lunch to rival any meal at a five-star restaurant.
This is only lunch. What do they do for dinner? Ah, the midnight sun, huh?
The only thing left to be satisfied is the desire to hook up with a Norwegian salmon. So Doug and Tyrell give this pool another try. The salmon continue to refuse the fare offered them. So it is time for Doug to pursue the fish in a new mountain stream. In Norway, there are thousands of choices. We'll visit one of them when Sportsman's Challenge continues.
Skeeter presents Sportsman's Challenge, brought to you by Skeeter, designed to fish, engineered to last. Yamaha Outboards, the only outboard with a 2-year warranty. Mustad, the fish hook people. Be sharp, use Mustad. Stanley Bates, we set the standard, you set the hook.
In Norway, the Repperfjord River is famous for its salmon population. So Doug and Tyrell make their way to a new pool in the river, a little bit higher in the mountains. The salmon are making a journey of their own at these falls. The water is still crystal clear. However, the rolling current makes fishing a bit easier. Our anglers aren't quite as visible. What the salmon do see is a delicate fly cutting a path overhead, a fly especially designed by Tyrell. These salmon like what they see.
Oh, there is one.
Tyrell, do you have one?
Yeah, it's only a small one, but it's a salmon.
I want to help even if it's small. Gosh, I've never seen one. Let me put my stuff down.
It's not a big fish, but it's fun to have him on the hook.
Where is it?
It's out there.
Well, it's gotten in the current, hasn't it?
Yeah, but now he's coming on the calm water, so it will be easy to...
It brings him back to us?
Yes.
You're tricky.
Here it comes.
That's not so small.
Oh.
Maybe for you. You need help?
Yeah, if you could grab the salmon, could you grab this tail on the salmon?
I'd be glad to grab this.
It's not big. Oh, he's colored. You can see that?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been in the river for some time.
So the darker they get, they're silver from the ocean?
Yes. If he is fresh, he would have had lice on.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Sea lice, like bumps?
Bumps? Yes.
Keep them in the water. So beautiful.
Yeah, they are.
This is why you live up here.
Yes. It is. And now it's your turn to catch one. Okay.
Okay.
No, I release him. Okay.
Great.
Oops.
The ice is broken. Still, Doug relies on a bit more coaching from the expert on salmon fishing.
Yeah. Hi, dog.
Yeah.
Come over here.
I see some more fish here. Okay.
I think you should try to stand here.
Is the fly I'm using okay? I've got the little brown and blue one.
I think you should try another one. I have one ready here on the one I brought. Yeah, you take that one.
Okay.
That's a special pattern. It's a special special green Highlander. It's very good for these waters, yeah.
You added to them well. It's brighter than normal.
It is.
Yeah, it's a lot brighter than normal.
We try to get the fly on the other side of that current and get the drift down.
Okay. We need what? 40, 50 feet?
Not very much. About 50 meters is more than enough.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Pick it up and see.
Not too far.
The Bass Professor is a good student, and Terrill proves herself an excellent coach who knows how to call the shots.
Big one.
There, very good. And you mend upstream, so the fly will just cross the current. There. I have a feeling now that we'll get a fish soon.
And then, as it comes down.
Yeah, in the calmer water, you have to strip it. Yeah. Yeah, move the fly. Okay, because the salmon can follow your fly and he can bite quite close. So you fish out your cast and start another one before you start another one.
Just tight, no sand.
Yes, don't give him slack. Just reel him.
He's coming up current. Oh my gosh, when he gets in that current.
Wow.
He's entered the current now.
In fly fishing, catching the fish is only half of the experience. We'll create the perfect fly when Sportsman's Challenge continues.
Now you have one.
Keep it off the rocks, right?
Yeah. You keep the line off, out of the water.
He's just coming up in the current. I'm trying to get the line back.
You don't give him slack.
No. Oh my gosh. He would have fit on the other side of the current. I have to get him through that to get him back.
Oh, yes. No problem, we have backwater here, so he will just, just let him go.
He doesn't go over the fall. So strong.
Yes, sir. This must be a couple of kilos.
How much?
A couple of kilos, I would guess. He's going into the current again.
I don't want to lose this. I came 5,000 miles for him.
You must keep contact with him all the time.
I want your big two-hand rod.
Yeah, but it's more fun playing him on the one-hand rod. Yeah. Here he comes.
I would really appreciate it if you would catch him.
I will.
There's your fly you made. You made that fish.
Oh, yes. Your fish. Congratulations to your first salmon.
Oh, thank you so much.
Believe it or not, the salmon is here, caught, and about to be released because of something that happens in Terrill's home in Elver Room. Inside is the workbench where Terrill creates the flies she uses.
Terrill, this fascinates me because, you know, we've fished the trout and all with the dry flies and these very natural looking insects. And then when I look at some of these salmon flies, they're intensely colored and the contrast in them, even the design, they're certainly beautiful, certainly art, but unrealistic in the sense that these insects don't exist, do they, in the real world?
No, they don't. And that's because the salmon, he don't feed in the river. He don't eat when he go up to spawn in the river. So The flies we make here, we make often colorful to mm-hmm. irritate him or make some interest so he will come and take the fly. Mm-hmm.
There's something, I guess, in all of these that's your own individual design, whether...
Oh, yes, and but it's not only my own color combinations, mm-hmm. it's also old fly tires, old fishermen's patterns.
Right.
Which I do my way with the crocheted body. I use very often fox hair, very soft hair, and I tie them in small bunches, but it's much stronger. And even in heavy current, my wing will stay like have a very beautiful silhouette,
uh-huh.
and it leaves.
I noticed that you put contrasting colors together to bring the bring the colors out, so the colors seem brighter than they
yes.
would by themselves, don't they?
Also, very important is many of the old traditional patterns had a lot of feathers,
mm-hmm.
And those feathers are many of them now on the CITES lists. They're illegal to use.
Okay, so they're endangered birds or protected?
Yeah, they are. And I want my flies to look pretty, and I want them to be strong. That's why I crochet their body.
They are beautiful.
Cheryl is now teaching her innovative crochet technique to others who are producing them for Mustad. When we come back, Doug and Cheryl explore new water which flows from ancient traditions.
Skeeter presents Sportsman's Challenge, brought to you by Skeeter, designed to fish, engineered to last. Yamaha Outboards, the only outboard with a 2-year warranty. Rattle Trap, nothing works like a rattle trap. Mustad, the fishhook people, be sharp, use Mustad. Stanley Bates, we set the standard, you set the hook. Air transportation provided by Scandinavian Airlines. Easy as SAS. For more information about Fishing Norway, contact the Norwegian Tourist Board, 212-885-9700.
This spectacular land is home to some of Norway's oldest inhabitants, the Sami or Lapp people. They are reindeer herders by trade, fishermen by necessity.
There is the inlet in the lake where the river comes into the lake.
Okay.
There's always a nice place to start.
Because trout
fish, yeah.
prefer flowing water, or is it because of all that washes in?
Yeah, all that washes in.
Experience tells our Lapp guide that the fish have migrated elsewhere this time of year. The chances of catching the trout, which are always here in June and July, are not so good in August. But expert anglers like Doug and Tyrell can learn from every fishing trip.
There and there, he says.
Uh-huh.
Today's adventure is no different. In many ways, the ancient Lapp culture is a mirror of Native American culture in the United States. The old traditions are revered, but they are giving way to modern invention. The Sami people keep the old ways alive by sharing them with others.
Yes, I will say you all welcome inside to the tent now. So, I will say you welcome inside this labo. This tent is called in Sami Labo. We can sleep here, we can do our work here, and we can also eat, serve the food.
You like it?
Nobody went like this. This is great.
Yes.
Unbelievable.
Doug's journey to the trout and salmon streams in Norway is only the beginning of this adventure. There was an ocean of fishing excitement just over the horizon in the Norwegian Sea. In an upcoming edition of Sportsman's Challenge, Doug teams up with a member of the Mustad deep sea fishing team, Geir Sivertsen. They are in search of one of the strangest and ugliest creatures lurking in these waters, the wolffish. Don't miss it.